Good morning, everybody. My name is Elder John Wright, and I will be the teacher today for our Sunday school class. It'll be lesson 6, April the 5th, 2020. And the title of our today's lesson is God's Just Servant. But before I start off, I do want to start off with a word of prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, God, we just come before you today, God, just to welcome you in this place, God. Father, as those that are viewing us, oh, God, by Facebook or whatever social media platform, I just, Lord God, ask that you would touch their hearts, oh, Father God, even comfort those right now, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ. And God, we welcome you in this place as we go forward in teaching your holy word. Amen. Amen. And like I said, today's lesson is God's Just Servant, and we will cover the Bible basis. We'll be coming from Isaiah 42:1-9. And today's Bible truth is Isaiah prophesies about God's servant who will restore justice, the coming Messiah. Our memory verse, behold, my servant whom I uphold, mine elect in whom my soul delighteth. I have put my spirit upon him. He shall bring forth judgments to the Gentiles. And today's lesson aim, by the end of the lesson, we will evaluate the concept of Messiah. And sense the wonder of Jesus' role as servant to the nations and imitate Jesus as a servant of God who executes justice. And our background scripture is Isaiah 42. Read and incorporate the insights gained from the background scriptures into your study of the lesson. Now, as I was reading this lesson, it really stood out to me, and it also pointed out some things to me that made me do some self-examination even in myself. And I hope this lesson will also do that, as you should take self-inventory of yourself. Amen. And as I want to start off this, he said, behold. This is the first verse in Isaiah 42. Behold, my servant whom I uphold, mine elect, in whom my soul delighteth. I have put my spirit upon him. He shall bring forth judgment to the Gentiles. I just want to focus right quick on the word servant. Now, as he says, behold, in other words, look, this is my servant. He is the great solution. There is none other, it is none other but Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior himself, amen? And I'm also reminded of Philippians 2:6-7. It says, who's been in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And as we look at that word servant, it said he took upon himself the form of a servant. So that should let us know that our example is Jesus Christ. So we should not be looking to self-glorify ourselves or put ourselves in the spotlight, but we should be a servant, have a servant attitude. Amen? Amen. And now to be a true servant, we must be obedient and you must be humble, not weak, not a doormat, but a servant. I believe one of the best definitions of servant is to be teachable. A servant serves. In order to serve, you must be taught how to, and you must be trained. You must also be teachable. Not only to those people that are great. You may look at bishops and you want to sit up under a bishop or some great man, but you should also be able to learn from those people who don't have titles. You should be able to learn from anybody, amen. You should be able to look at a child and learn something from a child, amen. So even as we go further, I don't want to spend too much time on that. It says, in mind elect, mind chosen. And we know that he's talking about Jesus Christ. He is the elect of God. He is the chosen by God to bring forth salvation unto man. And as we go on before, he said, I have put my spirit upon him. I have put my spirit upon him. That means approval. We know that and a person can get a job or get a title and you don't necessarily approve of that person, but they fit the job, they get the job done. So, but we look at God, say, I have put my spirit upon him, and he shall bring forth judgment to the Gentiles. And as we move to the next verse, he said, He shall not cry nor lift up nor cause his voice to be heard in the streets. That means that Jesus, when he came, he was not pointing to himself, but he was always pointing to the Father, as we should be pointing to Jesus. As you look at it, We are pointing to Jesus, and Jesus is pointing to God. And, you know, that is how we should live our lives. That's how we should be an example. We should always talk about Jesus Christ. We should not be pointing the spotlight on ourselves. Oh, no, when I get to this verse, I got another verse that I hope I can get to that is really going to bring that statement home. And it says, a bruised reed shall he not break, and the smoking flax shall he not quench. He shall bring forth judgment unto the truth. And as I was looking at this, it says, a bruised reed. Those people that are broken, you may feel like right now in your life, you're at that point where you feel like you're broken and you're in a disadvantaged spot. But we can take heart, we can take comfort knowing that Jesus Christ has come for those people that feel downtrodden. He said, he shall not quench the flax. Amen. So we know that even that you may think that you're at your point of extinction, that you think this is the end for me. I've tried, but we should be able to take comfort even in these trying times that you know that Jesus Christ has come for the people that he said, I don't come for those that are healthy, but I come for the sick. Amen. So we look at that right there, knowing that Jesus, he does not dismiss those that society dismisses. I think that is something else. We cast away those who we think are not valuable, but Jesus reaches out to those people, those who we dismiss and think that are not worthy, think that they don't have any value, but those are the people who Jesus, who he gathers, who he goes after. Amen. So we thank God for that. And even as we move on to verse 4, he said, he shall not be discouraged. And as I looked at that verse, he shall not be discouraged till he has set judgment in the earth, and the isles shall wait for his law. And as I read that verse, it reminded me of Jesus when he, from his childhood on up, from his youth to his adulthood, when he separated from his mother and father, when they found him, he said, don't you know I was about my father's business? From the youth, he was about his father's business, even to the adulthood on the cross when he said it was finished. So he was always about his father's business. He did not let anything discourage him. Amen. And neither should we. Jesus Christ is our example. He is God's just servant. So everything that Jesus did, how he operated, the demeanor that Jesus Christ had, we should also have that same demeanor. We should also have that same perseverance, that we will not let life, we will not let people, we will not let sickness, we will not let what is going on even today in our time with this COVID-19, we will not let these things discourage us or cause us to give up and lose heart. Amen. And as we move to verse 5, it says, thus says God the Lord, he that created the heaven and stretched them out, he that spread forth the earth and that which cometh out of it. He giveth breath unto the people upon it, and the spirit to them that walketh therein. And as I look at that verse right quick, he says, thus says God the Lord, letting you know that I am God, I am creator, I am the one that created this. And how this brings comfort to me also, knowing that our creator has not forgotten his creation. That he is not a delinquent father. He's not a deadbeat dad. But what he created, he takes care of. Amen. That should be a good lesson for these men and women out here that who have children that may not be doing what you should do. Be an example like your father. Amen. As we go to verse 6, I, the Lord, have called thee into righteousness, and I will hold thine hand. Now, it says when God calls you, God, he equips you. You know, that's what I get out of this verse right here. When God calls you, he does not call you to be a police officer and only give you a badge and don't give you a gun. But when he calls you, he gives you the authority, and he stands behind you and backs you up. You know, it's nothing worse than having a uniform on as a position, but you have no authority. The people that appointed you don't back you up. But we thank God that we have a Father in heaven that when he calls us, he equips us. He anoints us for the job at hand. Amen. And verse 6, he said, I, the Lord, have called thee into righteousness, and I will hold thine hand. That means that he will support us. He will keep you. Amen. So I really love these verses. And as I was reading these verses right here, he just really just made me think about today and how that our God is faithful and just. Amen. So as we go to verse 7, to open blind eyes and to bring out the prisoners from the prison, and to them that sit in darkness out of the prison house. Now, as we look at that, Jesus said he come to open the blinded eyes, those that are in darkness. He comes to set the captives free, those that are bound by the enemy, those that seemingly think that they're living a life of luxury and freedom, but don't realize that they are blind and that they are bound by the enemy. Amen? And so as we move on to verse 8, I am the Lord. That is my name. Let me know that I am God. I am creator. I am the one that rules. Amen? So I just really, really love these verses. This lesson has been such an encouragement to me. And he said, my glory will I not give to another, neither praise to graven images. The God says that all the glory should go to me. And as I close out, behold, the former things are come to pass and the new things. Now, I want to get to this verse really quick because I'm running out of time here. I want to jump right quick to John 15 and 15. Now, he says, behold, the former things are come to pass and the new things do I declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you. Now, if we go to John 15 and 15, it says, henceforth, I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. Now, isn't that a comfort to know that our God, he upgrades us from servant to friend. And that means a more intimate, closer relationship. And we always know that God wants to be closer, wants us closer to him than we actually do. And as we look at verse 16, he says, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that ye should go. Go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. Now, I love that verse. It really strengthened and it brought it home. It was the anchoring verse in this whole Bible study lesson to know that God will move us past the title of servant and bring us unto friendship. Amen. So I just want, before I close out, I want to close out with a word of prayer. I do hope that this lesson has encouraged someone on this morning. Amen. So I just want to thank you, Father God, right now for this time. We thank you, Father, for the lesson, God, to know, God, that you, Lord Jesus, that you are the just servant and that we should take an example from you, that we should live our life according to how you serve. You did not seek to glorify yourself, but you always directed us unto the Father. And Lord Jesus, help us to direct everybody that we meet and we stand before to point to you. We should not only be the person standing on the stage declaring your word, but we should be the man working behind the scenes with the spotlight. As they are speaking, we are pointing the spotlight, Lord Jesus, to you. And let our light shine that we might direct men and women to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Thank God. Amen. Amen.